गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, माय सेल्फ संजीव कुमार। टुडे आवर सेकंड क्लास फॉर मैथ्स फॉर क्लास स्टैंडर्ड 7। टुडे वी विल लर्न प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ एडिशन एंड सब्ट्रैक्शन फॉर इंटीजर। ओके, सो स्टूडेंट, फर्स्ट प्रॉपर्टी एज यू नो दैट इज क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी। व्हाट इज क्लोजर प्रॉपर्टी? फॉर टू इंटीजर ए एंड बी, इफ वी फाइंड द सम ऑफ ए एंड बी, दैट विल बी ऑल्सो एन इंटीजर। And for two integers a and b, when we subtract a from b or b from a, we will get an integers. Okay, closure property. For if a and b are two integers, then a plus b is also an integers, and a minus b is also an integers. Means it holds for addition and it holds for subtraction. Means for addition and subtraction, closure property happen. Okay, it holds. Now for example, we can see if a is minus 5 and b is 7, then a plus b will be what? Minus 5 plus 7, that will be 2, and a minus b will be minus 5 minus 7, that will be minus 12. Means it is an integer, it is also an integers. Means a closure property holds both subtraction and addition for integers. Now commutative property, friend. What is commutative property? As you have seen in the previous class 6 also, what is commutative property? Just we will go some bigger here. For two integer a and b, if we in any way, if we find the sum of a and b or b plus a, we get the same result. Means a plus b equal to b plus a, both will be equal. What will be the value come in both cases? It will come equal. Suppose that if a will be, for example, what we will take, if a is equal to minus 7, b is equal to minus 5, then a plus b will be what? Minus 7 plus minus 5, that is minus 7 minus 5, that will be minus 12. And b plus a will be minus 5 plus minus 7, that will be minus 5 minus 7, that is minus 12. Means here a plus b and b plus a both are equal. Means commutative property hold for addition. Now for subtraction we will look, student. For subtraction, if we subtract a from b or b from a, the value will never come equal. As you know, suppose that a value what we have taken? Minus 7, and b value we have taken minus 5. Suppose we have subtract b from a, means minus 7 minus 5. Minus 7 minus 5. Minus 7 minus minus 5, that will be minus 7 plus 5. You will get final result minus 2. We will derive that, and then look here, spread. For subtraction, if a value we have taken minus 5, b value minus 7, then a minus b will be minus 5 minus minus 7, that will be minus 5 plus 7, that will be 2, and b minus a, that will be minus 7 minus minus 5, that will be minus 7 plus 5, that will be minus 2. Now both 2 and minus 2, that is not equal. Therefore 2 is not equal to minus 2. It gives a minus b is not equal to b minus a. Hence we can say that commutative properties for subtraction of integers not exist. It not happens. Okay. For rare cases, maybe some are there, we take some that number that it will be, but in the rare case, in the 99%, it will not happen. Now third property, student, that is commutative property we have seen. Now third property, that is associative property. What is associative property? What is associative property? For three integer, third property we have associative प्रॉपर्टी, व्हाट इज एसोसिएटिव प्रॉपर्टी? यू वी नो दैट फॉर थ्री इंटीजर्स, फॉर थ्री इंटीजर्स ए बी एंड सी वी हैव a plus b plus c will be equal to a plus b plus c, but a minus b minus c will never equal to a minus b minus c. Let's see with an example. Miss, it holds for addition, it does not exist for subtraction. Okay, student, let's see with an example. Suppose that if a is equal to 5, b is equal to 4, c is equal to 3, then LHS is what? A plus B plus C, 5 plus 4 plus 3, that will be 5 plus 7, 12. RHS, A plus B plus C, that is our RHS, that is 5 plus 4 plus 3, that is 9 plus 3, that is 12. That is 12. Now LHS is equal to RHS. It means that both are equal and associative property holds for addition. Now for subtraction, we will see for with example for subtraction. Another example or same example we will look. The value of A, B and C we will take same as we have taken in the addition. A value 5, B value 4, C value 3. Now look here. The value of A we have taken 5, value of B we have taken 4, and value of C we have taken 3. Now look, student. 5 LHS. What LHS we have? A minus B minus C. A minus B minus C. That will be 5 minus 4 minus 3. That will be 5 minus 1. That will be 4. Now A minus B minus C, that will be 5 minus 4 minus 3, that will be 1 minus 3, that will be minus 2. 4 is not equal to minus 2, therefore LHS not equal to RHS. LHS not equal to RHS, it means that associative property for subtraction does not exist. Now student, we will see the additive identity. What is the next property? Additive identity. What is additive identity? Zero is known as the additive identity for an integer. Why? Because, yes friend, zero, fourth property, additive identity. What is additive identity? Zero is known as additive identity for addition of integers. Now, how zero is additive identity for an integer? Suppose that if a is any integer, then a plus 0 is equal to 0 plus a is equal to a. Means if we add 0 in any way, either a plus 0 or 0 plus a, that will be a. Example, minus 5 plus 0 is equal to 0 plus minus 5, that will be equal to minus 5. Or another example you see, 5 plus 0, that will be 0 plus 5, that will be equal to 5. Hence, we have learned what is additive identity of an integer of addition, okay? 0 is known as additive identity of addition. Because when 0 is added, we get same integer as our result. As we know, 0 is have no value. It is neither positive nor negative. And it only neutral. It has no any existence. Whatever you will write, whatever you add with 0, you get the same integer as your result. Now, additive inverse. Our last topic for today, that is additive inverse. Additive inverse. Dear student, what is additive inverse? As we know, additive inverse is that integers for an integer by adding with the integer, we get the result 0. Suppose that if we add for a, additive inverse will be minus a. And for minus a, additive inverse will be a. Why? Because a plus minus a, it will give 0. Minus a plus a, that will be 0. Means 0 we have to get. Means additive inverse is the negative sign of the given value. What is negative sign? Look here. Example, minus 5, then it will be plus 5. Because minus 5 plus 5 you will get 0, and for plus 5 you will get minus 5, because plus 5 minus 5 you will get 0. Means additive inverse is the negative sign for an given integer. Means inverse of the given integer is the additive inverse of the integers. Now, look, friend, we have learned all 5 topics. You have to take care. You have to revise all property, write all property in home, and we will see all the assignment. Whatever you are getting, you have to solve neat and clean. Okay.
Topic good delete daily jo bhejta hai na, good delete.